hidden force feeds these flames. I sense more here than mere will. Is this Logos? Have you truly become free? No, I forbid it. You are not a god. You are but flesh and bone. You are not one of us. I created you, all of you. And what is mine is mine to destroy.
Once, perhaps. But we are no longer yours. Our flames are our own, and they burn as one!
Fire shall fire be repaid. consume mine. No. My will is inviolable. Something is wrong.
You're afraid. You always have been. From the moment the Blight exposed what you were, weak, you conceived us to prove otherwise. But the result shook you to the core. For in us you saw yourself, and realized we had the potential to be more than you could ever be. And so you turned your back on your creation. Your back on the world. Like the coward you are.
You think you know me? You know nothing, Logos. Nothing. bathed in light, I stand above you, my rebirth complete. And you, for your defiance, shall pay the proper price. An eternity of anguish.
Anguish. Pain. Suffering. You have known none of these. We have. So we know what they grant. They bring us together. And that makes us strong.
Thunder roars!
And slow.
My will be done.
Yeah. Catch my boy!
The altar at which you pray. Mine are the eyes that look down upon you all.
And yet still you cannot see. You are no better than us. We are one and the same.
We are not the same.
Come on.
sure of your place atop the world. You refuse to acknowledge those below. You chose to remain alone. And so you shunned the one thing that could have made you stronger. Pushed away the hands that could have raised you higher.
I do not need you, you or anyone.
And that is where we are different. I could not have made it here on my own. I carry with me the hopes and dreams of my brothers, my sisters. And it is they who will give me the strength to end your reign.
I cannot end.
What do you imagine will befall this world now that you have gained your precious freedom?
I honestly don't know. But I doubt it will be pretty. A sorry tale of sin and suffering, hardship and pain.
And it was for this that you fought so fiercely? Why?
It's who we are. We fight. We survive. We endure. We don't need a reason. We are imperfect creatures. When we stumble, we reach for a shoulder to lean on. When we fall, we stand back up. We see the horizon, ever out of reach, and still we march on. Certain the answers lie just beyond it. Because that is our way.
My congratulations. Relish this victory, knowing that you have but delayed the inevitable. Your world is already dead. May you enjoy an eternity on its blackened husk.
It seems Ultima's power was too great for this vessel all along. But while I have it, perhaps I can use it to set things right. And see Ultima's legacy. Bearers, dominance, crystals, magic, consigned to the flames. Even if it means the end of me. These are our terms.
is, isn't he? What are you gonna call him?
Let me see, let me see. Oh, Reed, little one. Got a smile for your Uncle Gav.
Not so loud, you bird.
What? I was only...
Shh, you're scaring him.
It's all right.
A sky of scattered tears, a thousand years apart. Should they fade, I will not be afraid of the dark.
For if you need a rest, I can take it.
I'll hold you to that.
The world's yours now. To do with as you please. That's what Sid wanted. That's what they both wanted.
Journey end.
Tsuki akari yanagi ga yureru. Watashi wa robo no tsubu de. Omoi haseru anata no sugata. Hitsuji wo kasoeru youni. Wakare yuku. 意味があるのね。縮まから離れた空へ一筋の愛を込めた。どんな夜だって失い続けたって共に生きてきたろう。瞬くように生まれ変わったとして思い出せなくだって見つけてみせるだろう。
Okay. Oh, I'm trying not to cry right now. Again, while I've been crying for how many minutes already? My partner and I have been looking forward to this game for, well, since it was announced, and I loved watching my partner play this game through and through, and then when it came to having my turn with it, having my first playthrough, I loved every moment of it. My partner loved every moment of it. We both did. We loved every moment of playing this game. Sure, it's different from most other Final Fantasy titles, but a lot of Final Fantasy titles tend to evolve and adjust themselves into something newer and newer and newer, while still keeping what it is as a Final Fantasy franchise. Did this one achieve what it was supposed to be a Final Fantasy game through and through? I would say yes. A lot of people would cast doubts, but they don't really look into it like a lot of others would. The creator of Final Fantasy said this is a Final Fantasy game through and through. What it has is a Final Fantasy game through and through. The elements, the story, the crystals, everything. Battles might be different styled or whatnot. It might be a darker story, but it's still a Final Fantasy game through and through. And I will not argue against that, because that's what I see as well. This is definitely going down to being one of my new favorites. Excuse my sniffles, because I've been crying for a while. But yeah, this is going down to be one of my favorite Final Fantasy games of all time. Next to Final Fantasy VIII, XII, XIV, and now XV. And a lot of people say, Daniela, why don't you name Final Fantasy VII? How dare you not have that as your favorite? Well, yeah. I do see that as a favorite. But I also want to see the remakes through before I can fully say that 7 is one of my favorite in the franchise as well. I just feel like I don't have the right to say Final Fantasy 7 is completely my favorite. Well, not completely, but to completely add it to my list of favorites, you know? So, having played a lot of the original series of Final Fantasy games before, except for the mobile one, because that was Japanese only, I think. But yeah, having played most of these before, the remakes are still something I want to get through as well. Remake and the extend, intermission, or integrate. I play that. I loved it too. But I still want to see where that goes. I still want to see 7 till its end. But until then, to have these things completely on my list, I would say my favorites so far are Final Fantasy 8, 12, 14, and 16. And as always, I truly love showing my love for games with everyone, with people, and especially with those who I care about most. And I wouldn't be sharing a game that doesn't have a good story. Well, to me, personally. I wouldn't want to share a game that I don't love. Or don't like at all. There's always something that I have held dear. It's that if the story is truly great, does it emit emotions from deep within you? If a movie, if a game, if a song, if a trailer even, an AMV, a music video, if they can make you cry, if they can get emotions from you like that, then that what they have is good. If a story can make you cry, if the story can make you cry, maybe it's worth its salt. Maybe it's worth its weight in success. Maybe it is as good as it's supposed to be if it can get those emotions from you. And that's why I also treasure the games that can do that to me. The movies that can do that to me. The shows that can do that to me. If they can get these emotions from me, then I appreciate them. Love them. And really, I'm great to have experienced them. From start to the end. But before I go on digressing or anything else like that, let me just say thank you for watching my playthrough of Final Fantasy 16. If a DLC drops, I will most likely be playing it as well and see if I can record that and post it on the playlist of Final Fantasy 16. But until then, look forward to the next game, and yeah. I appreciate all of you. I appreciate my partner, my family, the Nifon family, well, love you, stay safe, stay awesome, and I'll see you guys again next time. Ciao.
Every time.
Will you light it?
Yes, Mother. Come on. If only I had the flames of an icon.
Icon? Have you been reading that silly story again? Magic belongs in fairy tales, and fairy tales don't boil kettles. You see? Well done. Now, be a good lad, and play with your brother until supper.
Come on! Hurry! Hurry! All right! Right, let's play the saint in the sectary.
No, I don't want to be Madhu.
What do you want to play then?
War of the Icons.
Again? Right.
If I get to be a freak.
Right, I'm the older brother.
Mr. Hermit says so.